WatchOS 3 has completely rethought how you use the Apple Watch. Here's everything that's changed. Alright, so getting started, there's now new and easier ways to navigate. Now there are two main ideas when it comes to navigation. You have your watch faces and you have your apps. The watch faces are now easier to switch between. Now doing a full swipe across the screen changes that watch face and you can go back and forth between whichever one you have. And there are new watch faces included. There's a Minnie Mouse watch face that goes along with Mickey that allows you to customize their clothing, and if you tap on them, they will say the time aloud. There's also now activity watch faces. There's an analog version, a digital clock, and these all focus on the activity rings. Lastly is numerals, and this is a pretty simple watch face that displays a single number with the watch hands. On those watch faces, there's now greater support for complications, so some faces that didn't have them before now do, and there are new complications for built-in apps. Now, the other main way to navigate is to use something called the dock. Before you had glances, but now the dock is where you can see a preview of all your most commonly used apps. You get to it by clicking the side button, which used to bring up a list of contacts, but now you have your favorite apps in the dock. What's good about this is speed. The apps that are in the dock are continually kept in the watch's memory and information is updated in the background. This means that the apps launch almost instantly and the dock holds up to 10 apps that you use frequently and recently, and you can customize what is in there, so the most important apps that you use can be there when you need them. Where glances used to be, now you have a control center, similar to on iOS, so you can see your battery, you can lock and mute the watch, and many other settings that you would hope to have right on the fly. There is also improvements to activity tracking. Now there is a new sharing feature that allows you to compete with friends and family, and when working out, third parties now have access to the heart rate and gyroscope, and their apps are now able to run in the background. The Apple Watch is also smarter about what it's able to detect during a workout, so it makes tracking even more accurate. There's also new calibration for those in a wheelchair. There's a new setting that changes certain functions like time to stand and activity tracking to be more wheelchair focused. So now you have time to roll reminders and wheelchair pushes contribute to that activity goal. Now, there are also updated apps in WatchOS 3. One completely new app is called Breathe. This is made to help with relaxation and stress relief, and it guides you through some exercises both on screen and through haptic taps that you can feel. You can also be reminded to breathe, and this happens every 4 hours, similar to how you are reminded to stand. Messages also got a bit of a redesign to make replying faster, so no longer do you have to tap reply, you can just go directly to the option that you want, and there's a new scribble feature that allows you to write out the letters that you want to type, and this feature works for English and Chinese. There's also a new Home app, and this goes along with the Home app in iOS 10, and it gives you quick access to your HomeKit-enabled devices. Now, some other features include Apple Pay within apps in the Apple Watch, and a new feature that allows you to automatically unlock your Mac if you're wearing your Apple Watch, so you no longer need to type a password, similar to how you use Touch ID on your phone to unlock your watch. One final feature is called SOS. This is activated by holding down the side button, and when the Apple Watch detects that, it automatically calls local emergency services. It can detect your location as well, so it will call the correct number even if you don't know what it is, and once activated, your emergency contacts will be notified and your medical ID can appear for those emergency services. So those are some of the major changes coming in WatchOS 3. Most of the things that you were able to do before are still there, but the way that you do them has been totally rethought. This is still a beta, so we will likely see some changes before the release in the fall, but it gives us a good idea of what to expect. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to subscribe to see when new videos are out, and visit MacRumors.com for more. I want to thank you for watching. I'm Matt Gonzalez with MacRumors, and I'll see you next time.